I was falling apart when heaven rescued me. Recovered my heart, I want the world to see. I can testify, testify.
Hi guys, it's Mama Valerie again. Welcome to another Bible Bytes video. So good morning and happy Sunday. So this lesson was a little bit different for me. Usually I have ideas for my videos at least a couple weeks in advance, if not more. And this one was different. It came time for me to sit down and write out my lesson, and I still didn't even know for sure what I wanted to talk about. I had a couple different lesson ideas, but nothing really felt right when I sat down to write it out. And it was getting time where I needed to like quickly know what to write about, and I was praying for guidance like I always do, but I wasn't really feeling clear direction. Nothing was feeling right. So one of the days I was sitting there trying to work on my lesson, I ended up taking a break and I started scrolling through Facebook. And I was only on there for a few minutes, and during those few minutes that I was on Facebook, I saw a couple posts and comments that really were just kind of irritating to me and also just made me feel sad. And so while I was sitting here thinking about how irritating and discouraging those posts were on social media, God spoke to my heart and he gave me the topic for this lesson. He made it very clear to me. This morning, he wanted me to talk about loving our neighbors. And so I want to thank the people that were not so loving on social media. I want to thank you for your unkind, not so loving words, because you actually inspired this video this morning. So it's because of you. God spoke through you to my heart this morning on what to talk about in my lesson today. So guys, remember, God even works through the yucky stuff. And he spoke to my heart today on loving our neighbor, and that's what we're going to talk about. So we're going to start out our lesson this morning by going to Claire, and Claire is going to share a Bible verse with us. So over to Claire.
This is the message you have heard from the beginning. We should love one another. 1 John 3:11.
Thank you, Claire, for that verse. So I'm going to start my lesson this morning by asking you a question. What would your day look like if you were to do everything in love? How would your day look different? I think most of us, or at least a lot of us, don't really like to stand out. A lot of us don't really like having the spotlight on us. We're not necessarily comfortable being in the spotlight. Even myself personally, I don't really generally like having the spotlight on myself either. But I think most of us want to be really good at something. I think most of us want to be exceptional in some area. Wouldn't it be amazing if we could strive to be the best at love? What if we were the best at love? If we really tried to make that our aim? Lucky for us, we have an example to follow and copy, and that's Jesus. Ephesians 5:1-2 says, "Imitate God, therefore, in everything you do, because you are his dear children. Live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ who loves us." I really like the Message translation of these verses, and it says, "Watch what God does, and then you do it, like children learning proper behavior from their parents. Mostly, what God does is love you. Keep company with him, and learn to live a life of love. Observe how Christ loved us." It then goes on to say, "His love was not cautious, but extravagant. He didn't love in order to get something from us, but to give everything of himself to us." Love like that. We are supposed to love extravagantly and not to get anything in return, but to just give love. So maybe you're wondering, well, Mama Valerie, who's really my neighbor? Who does Jesus really want me to love? Well, a religious law expert actually asked Jesus this same exact question. And we're told in Luke 10:29 that the man asked Jesus this question because he wanted to justify his actions. And Jesus answered him on who he is supposed to love by telling this little story. And I'm going to share the story with you. He said to the religious law expert, he said, a Jewish man, and I want you to keep track of that bit of information, the man was Jewish. A Jewish man was traveling from Jerusalem to Jericho, and he was attacked by a group of thieves. They stripped him of his clothes, they beat him severely, and they left him half dead on the side of the road. By chance, a priest came along, but when he saw the man lying there, he crossed over to the other side of the road and passed him by. A temple assistant then walked over, looked at the man lying there, but then he also crossed over to the other side of the road and passed him by. Then a despised Samaritan, and I want you to keep that word despised in your mind, a despised Samaritan came along, and when he saw the man, he felt compassion. He went over to the man, soothed his wounds with olive oil and wine, bandaged them. Then he put the man on his own donkey and took him to an inn where he took care of him. The next day, he handed the innkeeper 2 silver coins and told him to take care of the man. He said to the innkeeper that if the bill were to run higher, he would pay him the next time he was there. Now, after telling this story, Jesus then asks the religious law expert, now, which of these 3 men acted like a neighbor to the man who was attacked? The law expert responded by saying, the one who showed him compassion. Jesus said, yes, you're right. Now you go and do the same. Okay, so I want to give you guys a little bit of a background to this story, even though I think it's pretty obvious to all of us who acted like a neighbor to the man who was attacked. But I want to discuss this a little more with you guys and give you a little background on this. So when Jesus was telling this story, he talked about a stretch of road that the Jewish leaders he was speaking to would have all been familiar with. They were familiar with this road, and they knew that this road ran through rocky desert areas where there were plenty of places for robbers and bad guys to hide. They knew it was a rough area, and they knew that many Jews ran into trouble along this road getting attacked. So that part of the story was relatable to them. They knew they could understand and relate to this story. What they wouldn't have expected, though, was for the Samaritan to be the good guy. They wouldn't have expected the Samaritan to be the good neighbor. You see, Samaritans at this time were looked down on and despised. Like it said in the story, they were despised by the Jews, and they were despised because they were of mixed race, and that is the only reason they were despised. The Jews did not like them and despised them because they were only part Jewish. They were part Jewish, and so they were looked down on and despised. So the Samaritan being the hero of the story was something that these Jewish leaders would have never expected, and that would have been hard for them to relate to. Yet he's the one who showed compassion, and he showed compassion to a Jew, someone who most likely despised him and his people just for being of mixed race. But what Jesus was teaching through this lesson, and what he taught time and time again while he was here on earth, was that our neighbors are not just the people who live near us. They're not just our friends and family, not just people who look like us and act like us and think like us. They're not even people who necessarily like us or that we necessarily like. Our neighbors are everyone, everywhere. So Jesus says in Luke 6:27, those of you who are willing to listen, I say, love your enemies and do good to those who hate you. With that statement, Jesus doesn't really leave any wiggle room as to who we're supposed to love. We're even supposed to love people who hate us and people that we don't necessarily like. We're supposed to love everyone and do good to everyone. And yes, that does mean our family and our friends and our actual literal neighbors that live next door to us. But we're also supposed to love everyone else. That means people on social media. That means people that are making rude comments on social media. That means the kid giving you dirty looks. That means the people talking about you behind your back. That means the people who argue with you about everything. It means your annoying siblings that may drive you crazy. That means the quiet kid who doesn't talk and nobody likes. It means everyone, our friends, our family, even people that we might not like, even strangers. I would even go so far as to say, it means people who are not even born yet. It means people who are coming in the future. We are supposed to leave a legacy of love for everyone. So, Jesus goes on to say in Luke 6:35, love your enemies, do good to them, lend to them without expecting anything in return, and then your reward from heaven will be very great, and you will truly be acting like children of the Most High, for He is kind to those who are unthankful and wicked. Sometimes it's easy to love our neighbors, but sometimes it's not. Sometimes it's going to be difficult to love our neighbor. And like the Samaritan, it can often cost us our time, our energy, and our resources. The temple priest and the temple assistant who passed that man by on the side of the road, they didn't want to be bothered with him. They didn't want to have to sacrifice and give. They didn't want to have to possibly miss their opportunity to serve in the temple. They weren't willing to sacrifice in order to love this man. They weren't willing to do whatever it took to love him, but the Samaritan was, and he was willing to do so even if he didn't get anything in return, and he likely wouldn't have gotten anything in return. But we are supposed to love our neighbors anyway. We are supposed to love them, and we are supposed to do it without wanting to get anything in return. And what Jesus promises us, though, is he promises us that he will reward us. He will reward us for modeling love to the world. So it doesn't matter whether or not we get something in return from the person we're loving, because Jesus is going to reward us. Do you guys remember in my perseverance video? In my perseverance video, I talked about how I pray for my kids every morning before they go to school, and I always pray that they will do their work for the Lord instead of for people. Do you guys remember that? The same principle applies to loving our neighbor. If we're doing it for the Lord rather than for people, it makes the task of loving our neighbors easier and more enjoyable. In fact, when Jesus was talking about the final judgment, and he was talking about dividing the righteous from the unrighteous, he says in Matthew 25:34-40, he will say to those blessed by his Father and inheriting the kingdom of heaven, I was hungry and you gave me food to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. I was naked and you gave me clothes. I was sick and you took care of me. I was in prison and you visited me. The righteous will reply, when did we ever do these things for you, Lord? And I will say to them, I tell you the truth. Whenever you did anything for the least of these, my brothers and sisters, you were actually doing it for me. Or actually says doing it to me. Both are applicable. When we are loving our neighbors, we're actually loving Jesus. That's what he's saying here. When we are loving our neighbors, whatever we're doing for them, we're actually doing to Jesus. We are loving him when we love the world. We live in a world that tells us to look out for ourselves, look out for number one. And in our culture today, I think we're almost even encouraged to hate those that think differently than we do. But that's not what Jesus taught. And we're supposed to imitate Jesus, and we're supposed to copy him. Jesus told us we're supposed to love everyone and love them and care for them as much as we love ourselves, if not more so. We need to love and remember that we're loving the Lord when we love others. What would the world look like if we made love our number one priority? What if we got out of bed every day thinking, how can I love better than I loved yesterday? What would our church look like if we made love our number one priority? How many more people could we win for Christ if we were getting up every day and trying to make love our number one focus for the day and thinking, how can we love better than we did the day before? What if we all got up every day and tried to outlove each other? What if we did that? That's pretty much what I challenged you guys to do this week. I challenged you guys, we kind of had a friendly competition of love. I wanted you guys to try to outlove each other this week and to send me videos of you guys showing love to the world, love in action. I asked you guys to send me love in action videos, and I sent you several different ideas of ways you could show love this week, and I wanted you to get video of it and send me the videos. So we're gonna go to those videos in just a minute, and you guys can enjoy the love videos that you guys sent me this week. I really want to thank those who participated. Some of you didn't participate, but I could tell you guys got the message. It's funny that God led me to talk this morning about loving our neighbor, because it actually kind of went along really well with what we talked about on Wednesday night in our youth group meeting on Zoom, which I'm not surprised. God always works things out like that. But on Wednesday, we were kind of finishing up our talk on body image, and I kind of went into talking about our hearts and talking about how we should be making ourselves attractive by making our hearts attractive, and that that's more important than the way we look on the outside. We need to be making ourselves attractive by having attractive hearts. And if we are trying to make love our focus and living lives of love, our hearts are going to be very attractive, and that's going to come through on the outside. So it kind of goes along well with what I was talking about on Wednesday night. I really, like I said, I appreciate those of you who participated. I know not all of you are comfortable being on camera. I think you guys really got the message though. Some of you maybe didn't do a love video, but I got texts this week from you guys giving me compliments. And some of you just sent me texts saying you love me. Kyla is always sending me sweet little texts telling me that she loves me and just being very positive and encouraging. And I got texts from other people too. Ashley Cox sent me a super sweet text this week complimenting me and saying that she liked the video from last week. You guys are getting it, and you are living lives of love. You guys have beautiful hearts. You really do. And I appreciate you guys, and I know you guys are gonna change this world. You guys are making a difference, and you are living lives of love. And so I really appreciate that. Whether you sent videos or not, I appreciate your loving hearts. And it warms my heart. And so I'm gonna share the loving videos after I pray. I'm gonna wrap up. Actually, I'm just gonna repeat the verse that Claire shared at the beginning of this video. 1 John 3:11, this is the message you have heard from the beginning. We should love one another. It's kind of a simple, short verse, but there's a lot of weight that comes with that. We need to be loving one another, everyone, everywhere. Show love, make love your aim and your focus. And wow, how much more effective will we be for the Lord if we make love our focus, if we try to be the best at love? I'm wearing my superhero shirt today. What if we were superheroes at love? That's what I want you guys to take with you. Go and love someone today after you watch this video. Show love. Remember my list I gave you of all those ideas of ways you can show love in action. Do something from that list, whether you get it on video or not. Go and do something from that list and show somebody love. So let's go ahead and pray, and then I'll do song recommendations, and then we'll go to our love videos. Thank you guys. All right, let's pray together. Dearest Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you so much for this day. I thank you for everyone watching this video, Lord. I thank you for your love, Lord. Thank you for this reminder this morning in this lesson of how we're supposed to treat each other and how we're supposed to love. Lord, help us to love more like you. Make love the first thing we think about when we get up in the morning and the last thing we think about when we go to bed at night. Fill us to the brim, Lord, with your love. Fill us till we're overflowing so that love just pours out from us, Lord, to everyone we come in contact with. Help us, Lord, to love even those who are more difficult to love. Help us to remember that their hearts matter to you and you love them. Help us to love them for you, Lord, even when it's hard. Help us to love, Lord, even when it costs us something, even when we have to give of our time and our energy and our resources. Help us to love, Lord, and thank you that you say you will reward us for modeling love to the world. Thank you for showing us, Lord, what real love looks like. Help us, Lord, to make loving others our focus. Help us to desire to be the best at love. Help us to imitate you, Lord, with our lives, and help us to live lives of love. Lord, I pray that you would just bless every single person watching this video this morning, Lord, and I pray that you would touch their hearts, Lord, and I just pray that you would give everyone watching this video an extra measure of your love today, and give them all a hug for me, Lord, since I can't hug them myself. I thank you and I praise you for putting each one of these people in my life, Lord, and thank you for the joy that they bring my heart. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys, so my song recommendations for this week. Actually, while I was doing this lesson all week, I had that song by Jamie Grace in my head, that song, Do Life Big. That kind of talks about loving too, and loving big. So that can be one of my song recommendations too. Do Life Big by Jamie Grace. I actually wanted to put in a video clip of you guys, a lot of you are in it, singing this song at church, and it was from several years ago. I think it was like 4 years ago, because it popped up in my memories on Facebook, and it was so cute to see like little Nathan and little Joel and little Luke and little Dreama and Katie, and you guys, or even littler, like baby Brayden and Sammy, they were tiny, and Izzy. I wanted to put that video at the end, but it's like a lot of Jamie Grace actually singing it, so I think I would probably get copyrighted and they might mute it. So I don't think I'm gonna put it in there, but I can show you guys sometime if you want, it's cute. So you can look up Do Life Big by Jamie Grace, and my other song recommendations are With Every Act of Love by Jason Gray and Native Tongue by Switchfoot. Those are my love songs for you guys today that you can look up. And now we're gonna go to our love videos that you guys sent in, and thank you for participating. Some of them may be harder for some of you guys to understand and see. I have some screen recordings from Joel. One screen recording is him texting a compliment to his mom, and then one is a screen recording of him posting something on social media. So hopefully you can read the words quickly. And then I have a picture actually that Kylie sent me that Katie had sent her. Kylie's been going through some stuff this week with her family, and her grandma's very ill, and Katie just sent her a really encouraging text and picture. I'm gonna try to put that in here too. Hopefully you guys can read the words. They're kind of small, but again, you guys are getting it. You're showing love to each other. So I'm giving Katie credit for that as a video, even though it's a picture that she sent to Kylie. She was showing love in action to Kylie. So I just get it. I'm happy and I'm so glad you guys got the message. You were showing love this week. So to our love videos, we've got kids playing with their siblings, giving each other hugs, loving their pets. We got a lot of stuff. So love you guys. I hope to see you all for Wednesday night youth group again. Our numbers are getting big. I think we had 24 or 25 of us total last Wednesday. Super cool. So see you guys Wednesday. Reach out at any time. Love you. Bye. So I felt the need to record a retraction, because when I did my lesson, when I recorded that video at the end, I kind of made it sound like I didn't get that many videos from you guys for your acts of love this week. And that's because at that point, I had only received a handful of videos. But then come Thursday and Friday, man, you guys really stepped up. The videos came like rolling in like crazy. I couldn't believe the amount of videos you guys sent in. I was literally like that emoji that goes like this. That's what I was thinking. I'm so proud of you guys. I can't believe how much you guys stepped up. You guys really were living out love this week, and I'm so proud of you. You guys did so many acts of love, and you proved it by sending me the videos, and I'm just super excited and proud, and I couldn't I don't even know. You guys totally surpassed what I was expecting when I gave you guys this assignment and tried to get you guys to outlove each other. It was super fun, great little competition, and you guys totally warmed my heart this week doing all these acts of love. So enjoy the video.
Love your neighbor. Here we are. We are doing a birthday party parade for a 5-year-old friend of ours. It's a birthday parade, so here you go. You get to witness our little birthday parade and see our little birthday girl. So this is showing love to your neighbor. So here we go. We're turning onto the street, and you'll get to see her as we go by. So here we go. We got a birthday song playing. And here's the birthday girl. Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Show love to your neighbor. That's right.
Brayden, you're really smart and great at math.
Okay.
Me and my sister Darla are coming together. 2 hours. Love you, Darla.
Love you.
Hi guys, I'm mailing out some loving notes today.
What is that? Oh, no.
Oh, that's cute.
Love you.
That's neat.
You just want to get me on there for something, huh?
No,
dash cam.
Dash cam. Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. Oh. What's behind your ear? Oh, it's a tag. Oh, hi, Edward.
Oh.
Mom. What, Rosie? What? What? Lucky? Having a hard time?
Yes. Hard time. It's a half cup of buttermilk.
That's a teaspoon?
Yes, this is a teaspoon.
That's tiny.
You want too much. You do not want too much sugar. Teaspoon of vanilla. Good enough to do a cooking show. Next, you show. Let's see if I could get this buttercream out.
It's obviously, actually.
Dropping off some flowers for Janice.
Packing up some clothes to donate to charity.
treats to Joel and Santa.
You messed up the recording. That is yours. There's candy and cards in there, and you have flowers, and now we're gonna go give Allie one. Okay.
Dropping off some treats for Luke.
Means a lot.
Okay. No?
Sounds like major tax up in the arena. Says you're on the free ride.
What?
My little baby.
Hi, Papa. How are you doing?
Fairly well.
Oh, good. I just wanted to call and tell you that I love you.
Hi, we on the trampoline. Let's bounce.
That's my head.
Oh! I do a flip.
Me?
Yeah.
Move that. Going that way.
Go, go, go.
I was falling apart when heaven rescued me. Recovered my heart, I want the world to see. I can testify.